fedratinib is approved in the frontline setting. The drugs were tested in parallel. Ruxolitinib has been on the market for a much longer period of time, so I think there's a much greater comfort level. It is included in the NCCN guidelines, particularly for individuals with intermediate to and high-risk disease. The reason for that difference is that symptomatic low risk and intermediate one risk are considerations if for myelofibrosis patients with ruxolitinib, but there's no data yet in those groups with fedratinib. They're both JAK2 inhibitors. As with any kinase inhibitors, they each kind of have their own unique profiles. Fedratinib was tested at full dose for patients with a platelet count between 50 and 100,000, and we've published on those data, so that might be a group for consideration in the frontline setting.